What is up, everyone? Soldier of Fortune here, and guess what? We are back in the Call of Duty game, 2025. Oh, only here in 21. That blows. Oh, well. So, yeah, guys, recently, you have probably noticed that I did 3 videos with my face and did some comedy stuff. Got great responses on that, but I'm not quitting on the Call of Duty stuff because I really am a part of the, I don't want to make it sound like, oh, I'm important. That's all, and what I'm trying to say is the gamer community is the community on YouTube I want to be involved in, which probably makes a lot of you go, why? Why would you want to do that? I don't understand. Because recently there's been lots of drama, and there always is a lot of drama around this time of year. Where you going, son? You can't escape the Soldier of Fortune. I'm the survivalist. Yeah, that's right, son. Get some. Because Black Ops 2 comes out in about a little shy of a month. In a month and a couple, maybe week or two. I'm not sure. Because it's October starts. So yeah, we've got about a month left, and then Black Ops 2 comes out, and the community always gets a little tense and dramatic and crazy around the time of a new game because a lot of emotions are going through those minds. A lot of people are going, oh, it's going to suck. I'm not going to buy it, but you do anyway. You know you do. A lot of other people are like, oh, it's going to be fantastic. And then the people who think it's going to suck criticize people who think it's going to be fantastic. I personally have high hopes for Black Ops 2 just because the only other option really is to kind of expect it to be crappy, and I guess I'm just hoping that we get a great game. I mean, I know a lot of people are like complaining about Modern Warfare 3, but I enjoy it. I love the survival mode stuff. I enjoy the maps, at least on survival mode. I've never really played the new maps on multiplayer, so I can't really comment or speculate in that area, but I don't know, I think sometimes the community has a tendency to be a little over-anal about everything. And again, remember, it's maybe about 20% the game's fault. 20% is the game. What the... My dog came out of nowhere and bit me. Anyway, it's about 20% the game's fault. Oh, and by the way, if my voice sounds a little weird, it's because I'm just coming off a cold. And I'm like, literally, this is like the second day I've had my voice back. Second or third-ish day that I've had my voice back, so it still sounds a little weird. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Turn around and knife her in the face. Anyway, it's about 20% of the community, the game developers and the game's fault, because they obviously put in the stuff that is BS. You know, they put in the second chance was 100% their fault, but they put in the stuff like, you know, Blind Dying Assassin, that we all know, the developers know, we know, is going to be taken advantage by all these punk kids who want to piss people off, and also by these, you know, baby little gamers who camp, douchebag gamers who camp to get all their kills. Oh, stuck on a box there. But yeah, all these jerks who just, you know, they're annoying. They really are. They just sit there and they're invisible. You can't hit them with anything, and they just take people out. And you have no, I mean, especially if there's like a long, like road like thing. How is it that I cannot get any money? Jesus. You know, like if there's like a long, path or whatever in the map, like this, and like, you're coming from this end, but this is walled off, and this is walled off, and there's someone there and there, you know, or they're, like, you need to get from this end to that end, you know, and it's the only way to get to, like, this group of campers that are taking out your guys, because there's, like, a hill right here or something. I don't know. It reminds me of Black Ops Jungle Map, that one spot that people would camp all the time. You can never get to them because people place claymores down. I don't know. I mean, it's a valid sniper spot, but when you got people camping the holy bejeebus out of that spot, it's like, okay, you can't even get to it to take the guys out, so it's not even a fair. Doesn't even give you a fair shake. which is just straight up annoying. But yeah, it's really the community that screws up a game and ruins it for everyone else and makes it no fun. And I mean, odds are people are gonna, you know, ruin Black Ops 2, and they're gonna be mean and annoying and take advantage of stuff, and you're gonna get frustrated and come back to Modern Warfare 3, and it won't be as bad. Why? Because all the annoying people, geez, I want to get an assault rifle, but I can't on money. I mean, all the annoying people, all the people who do that, migrate to the next game. So then this game, I mean, it's just like after this game came out, a lot of people would play Black Ops, and there'd be like, it'd be great, it'd be a lot of fun. Even play Modern Warfare 2, that was fun. You know, because all the campers are really gone. Although, Modern Warfare 2, the tubers kind of went to Modern Warfare 2 because they knew they could get away with it. But, I don't know, I just... Oh my god, there's people. Yeah, I mean, just people leave, the people who camp and everything leave one game for another. You know, and there's no way to make a game that is foolproof so people can't camp and can't take advantage. But, yeah, that's just my two cents on the whole thing. And I know there's a lot more drama going on YouTube with, you know, all this crap. I don't want to get into it because I don't want to feel like I'm ranting on, you know, my first gamer video after 3 months. I mean, it's not like I'm coming back into it, but, oh, wow, that was like Domino. 1, 2, 3. Just zipping them up. I love this. It's called the zipper. When you zip up, it's called the zipper. Oh, I can afford an assault rifle now, yay. But, yeah, and it's just, it's so much drama on YouTube, and I don't really want to get into it, and I never really used to get into it. I never even really used to realize it, but the longer I had a YouTube channel, now it's starting to kind of come to my eye. You know, I mean, just listing it off, just people making these BS one-minute YouTube videos, and then spamming the crap out of the, I don't know what the heck they're called. I don't know, the freaking words that, the tags, spam tagging the crap out of the videos, and it's just crap content just to get views. That's bad. And then, you know, people reposting, just watching other YouTubers that are successful and then copying what they do. And then there's always the just people making those stupid hater comments because people gotta hate, and they gotta be immature, and they gotta start comment wars, and they gotta do this and that. But like I said, I don't want to get into it because I've been ranting most of this video. And I really just kind of... I'm here to entertain you guys. And I'm here to make you guys giggle and laugh. And just enjoy your day. And yeah, I kind of realized I couldn't really do that with online. Like, I'm not so good at Xbox Live. We're going to be honest here. But I thought I'm pretty talented at this survival mode stuff. I mean, for some reason. And it's maybe just because it doesn't have any of the BS that Xbox Live does, or I don't know, it's easier for me for some reason because the AIs aren't as good. Well, it gets overwhelming at the ending, but yeah, guys, that's my video, and I'm going to end it looking at the train, the beautiful train station. Look at that. And I'm going to peace out, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoy the rest of your week, and keep on gaming. Soldier Fortune is out.